welcome to Cruise Line. I'm Lucas.
And I'm Sean.
And we're going to be talking about clubs. Do you like clubs?
Yeah.
Do you like trivia?
I think so.
Do you like questions?
You're asking kind of a lot of questions.
Well, I got a club full of questions and trivia. It's Quiz Bowl.
All right, well, let's check out that piece then.
Knowledge. The key to success. Today, we're going to sit down with the Lance Creuse North Quiz Bowl team to see what the staff and students think about Quiz Bowl and how it can help them in the future.
I joined Quiz Bowl because it was a club to join freshman year, and I was always kind of a little bit more intelligent than others, and that sounds really self-centered. Wow. Okay. It was just something fun to do, so.
Well, Mr. Lynch asked me to help out with Quiz Bowl about a year ago, so I love trivia, and that's what Quiz Bowl is all about. It's random knowledge that we all have so much of that we basically compete against other schools, and we just get asked questions about math, science, history, sports, you name it, and you just basically play in a trivia game.
I joined Quiz Bowl because of I saw Mr. Lynch in the hallway sitting at a table, and he was like, you'd be perfect for this, and I said, no, I wouldn't. He said, yes, you would. I want you to join. And I said, okay, and I signed up.
Well, I just wanted something kind of extra to do outside of school, and I just thought it was a good opportunity to join it, I guess.
Well, I think actually for kids, they should really sign up for this because, one, it looks good on college applications and college and for basically that, you know, you care about your school. It's an educational club that we do, and it just tests your knowledge and makes you more aware of knowledge you should know about.
Well, it's really like I learn a lot of new things every day, like every match we have, so I guess I can learn something I don't know.
Well, it can really help me in the future because I can have all these friends that I have here and we can all associate afterwards, but there are some questions that I can utilize later on in the future.
It's gotten helped me get accepted to more colleges because it looks really good on college applications, and yeah.
The kids who participate in Quiz Bowl is my favorite part. They're good kids, they like trivia, and those are my kind of people.
I like going to the other matches and getting to go there every week.
Because we have a lot of friends here and it's a good association of other people. We can all really get to know each other better, and that the more friends, you can never have enough friends. And if you go to Quiz Bowl, I guarantee you'll make at least three.
It's really fun for the most part. It's really competitive against other schools, and it's just it's a good way to find people.
Really just, I don't have one memory. I like going and while the kids are playing, I like seeing how much I know as well while their games are being played. So I just have fun going. So I think all the times we go is my favorite.
It's pretty fun. We get to, you know, see a lot of people from other schools, and it's like, it's a good learning experience. It's pretty fun.
Lucas.
Send me that link.
Well, we sure learned a lot about Quiz Bowl today.
Hey, Lucas, wanna go to Quiz Bowl?
Yeah, dude, let's
all
go.
Right, okay.
Quiz Bowl seems pretty fun. I like all the questions they ask. So let me ask you a question, Lucas. What's the next piece about?
Next piece is on Lance Creuse's Cabaret and who sings most of the popular songs in it.
I literally have no idea this is by. Wait, it's no, I have no idea.
All right, that song was by Queen.
Oh yeah, I didn't know that.
We Will Rock You by Queen.
We Will Rock You. Queen? I genuinely forgot that.
We Will Rock You, Queen.
We'll Rock You by Queen.
Yeah.
I don't know the artist. I know the name of the song, though. We Will Rock You. No.
Queen? Yeah.
I really don't know that.
I don't know.
Bon Jovi. Yeah.
You Give Love a Bad Name by Bon Jovi.
Shot Through the Heart. I forgot who it's by.
Bon Jovi. You Give Love a Bad Name.
You Give Love a Bad Name, Bon Jovi.
A bad name. Give me the
beat, boys, and free my. No, it's Give Me the Beat. I just don't know who it's by. Is anybody gonna kill me? Was that the Beatles?
No, I'll give you that one. It's Uncle Cracker.
Is it really?
Yeah.
You should know that. He's my neighbor. Was my neighbor.
Exactly!
It's Uncle Cracker.
Alright. It's like that song that's like, Give Me a Beat or whatever. I have no clue who it's by.
Oh, this is Drift Away by Uncle Cracker.
Yeah. Drift Away.
Drift Away by Kid Rock. I don't know. It's Kid Rock. Yes, it is. Am I close?
This song is Drift Away or Give Me a Beat, Boys by Uncle Cracker.
That's Uncle Cracker.
Yeah.
I'm so sorry. All I do is win,
win, win, no matter what. Wow, I actually didn't know some of those singers.
Yeah, me neither. I'm probably going to jam out in my car later. Well, the next piece is from Malcolm and Moe, and they're doing a piece on Lance Creuse's girls basketball team.
Welcome to this year's girls basketball team.
Dang, that's what I'm talking about. Give up. They're playing basketball. We love that basketball.
Hi, I'm Coach Downey. I'm the varsity girls basketball coach at Lance Creuse High School. I'm starting my 10th year here as the varsity coach. I am beginning my 36th year overall coaching basketball. I also coach varsity softball here. This year, the season is just beginning, so we've just got done with our tryouts. This is the first week of our practice with our regular team. We're looking forward to having an energetic team that has a lot of room to grow. We're very young with two freshmen and four sophomores on our varsity. So we have a lot to learn. The girls are really, really working hard. They get along well. They've got great attitudes, and I'm really upbeat and positive that we're going to have a really fun and exciting season this year.
Next up, let's hear from our Lady Lancers.
My name is Denia Beavers. I'm a sophomore. I'm a center on the Lance Creuse girls basketball team. I'm looking forward to winning lots of games this season.
Hi, I'm Christina Warner. I'm a senior and I play shooting guard. I'm looking forward to beating LCN and winning games.
I'm looking forward to beating North this season.
I'm looking forward to winning districts.
There you have it. Hopefully they have a good season.
Go support the Lady Lancers at their basketball games.
So let me ask you something, Lucas. What kind of kids do you see in your classes? You know, the class clown, the lazy ones, the copiers. Like, do you see those?
Yeah.
Well, Mateo did a piece on that. Let's check it out.
Listen, we all know we have those kids in class, you know. Tap their pencils, sleeping, or even the teacher's pet. So today I'm gonna go over what these students are and how to stop it from being you. Mateo, you gotta get up. Mateo, it's time to get up. So we carry the Y-U-N-G over the T. Mateo, wake up!
We all know someone exactly like that. So there's only one 100% way to stop that from happening. You can grab yourself an energy drink. Well, two. You could grab yourself a shower in the morning. Wake up a little bit earlier. I know you're gonna be tired, but once you hop in a hot shower, feel fine the rest of the day and won't make you tired. Now let's talk about the next one, which is the teacher's pet. We all know someone who is the teacher's pet. Honestly, there's nothing you can do to stop it. And the teacher has favorited this student out of everyone in the class. If the teacher picks you as a favorite, well, good luck, because you're not getting out of that one. Finally, let's talk about the pencil tapper. The pencil tapper is a kid who thinks he can make a Metro Boomin beat with two pencils or two pens.
Dude, stop.
Newsflash, you can't. There is only one simple solution from stopping this kid.
Give me that. You're not getting these back.
Well, there's that solution. Unless you're the teacher's pet. Because that's not really on you. But like I said, good luck. See you guys next time.
Well, that was pretty accurate on the types of kids in class.
Yeah, Lucas, I'm definitely some of those.
I sure am.
So what's the next piece about?
Up next, we have Taya's cabaret piece. Enjoy.
Every year, LCHS Choir puts on the show Cabaret. This year, the theme is rock and roll. Let's see what students and Mr. Kabobel himself have to say.
I don't know. It's such a really cool show. Like, I couldn't imagine, like, being in choir and not doing a cabaret. Like, such a mixture of different songs that it's, like, hard to explain. Like, normally it's Broadway songs, but this year it's, like, rock songs. And it's a lot of fun. And I think everyone's going to enjoy it because, like, normally people don't know Broadway songs. So they're like, oh, well, this is good, but I don't know any of these songs. But now it's all, like, throwback songs. Like, everyone's going to know it. Like, old people, young people. I think everyone's going to enjoy it because they're going to know, like, most of the songs. Mr. Kabobel, this being his last show and him leaving, it's sad, but I think it's going to be, like, cool, like, seeing who is going to come in, like, the new face, and seeing how, like, they're going to take it, because Mr. Kabobel has shaped such a great choir program that I don't want, like, a new person to come and, like, change the integrity of it, but I think it's, like, good and bad, so there's, like, pros and cons.
My name is Julie, and I've been in choir for 3 years. I started off in band for my first 2 years, and sophomore year I joined choir too, and decided I liked choir better. Cabaret involves a lot of dancing, just choreography in general. The other shows involve acting too, but it's like a different kind of energy in the show. I'm totally excited for this show.
My name is Dante Chambers, and I've been in choir a total of 5 years, but in high school choir for 2 years. Cabaret is different from all the other choir shows because it brings together a bunch of different songs, like not in any particular order, just like all together in one place. It's fun. I'm very excited for it because I feel like it's going to be a really solid show this year.
Hi, I'm Lauren Howard, and I've been in choir for 4 years. Cabaret is different from other choir shows because it's different from a musical because you don't have lines and you're not a special character. It's kind of more fun-based, so you have a certain theme and then you get to kind of just have fun on stage. I'm very excited about this show because not only is it really fun, like, topic, but it's also my last one, so it's kind of sad and I just love all the dancing we do. It's definitely sad that this is Mr. Kabobel's last cabaret, but I think this is really good for him, and he's going to be much happier once he is pursuing other things, so it's kind of a goodbye, but at the same time, it's a new beginning.
My name is Caitlin Bammel, and I've been in the choir program here at LC for 4 years. Cabaret is different from other choir shows because it's like a mix of a bunch of different music, and it's not all just like one setting and one era. It's like a huge, like, just mix of music. I'm very excited about the show because it's different from everything we've ever done before, because usually it's around like musical based and like musical numbers, but it's rock and roll themed and it's also my last one, so I'm very excited but also very sad at the same time. I'm very sad about it, only because over the years I've grown to love him, and the fact that it's my senior year and I don't get to finish it out with him, it's really sad, but I'm just happy he's here for the last one.
This year's Cabaret is themed on rock and roll bands of America and the Beatles as well, because they kind of started the revolution of rock and roll. This year's Cabaret is unique in the fact that it's my last one, and it was an idea that I brought from my student teaching experience in the form of dinner theater. We extracted the food, and it became Cabaret as an umbrella term for a musical review. And it will be missed because it's something that I get to create on my own, and it's the show that students have a lot of input with their own ideas and talents. The show's gonna go great because I've never had a failing show.
That was awesome. So go check out Cabaret from 7 to 9 today and tomorrow.
That's all for this episode of CreuseLine. I'm Connor.
And I'm Sean.
Signing out. See you next time.